Hi girls, it's Jenny with Planner Perfect, and in today's video, it's another plan with me.
Weather is for better.
Okay, welcome back. I want to talk a little bit about what is up for this week. And I feel like what I want to discuss briefly before we get into the plan with me video. Again, what I do recommend is that you get kind of you get the nuts and bolts down, you know, you get down the appointments that need to be laid down. The absolutes, I've always called them my absolutes, you know, get the absolutes down, of some appointments and different things of that nature. And then each night, or in the morning, early in the morning when you rise, pray about things first, have God lead, and where and what and how you want your day to go. You can do that. I know for me, I do like to lay out as much plans as I can and details as I can that I do know that I'm going to be doing. So certain things like routines, school projects for homeschooling. I like to get a creative ahead of time for grandchildren, for ideas of what to do for them. So, and I do have some business things that I have to do and some different adventures that I'm doing that I need to make sure those plans are kind of thought out and laid out in detail. Why detail? Because I really feel like the magic, and it always is, the magic is in the detail, because it really creates such a visual for you. It helps lay out a more overall view of your life instead of viewing it in bits and pieces in a to-do list. When you're really breaking down and thinking things and laying down your life in an intentional and purposeful way, when you write it in detail, you're visualizing, and when you're visualizing, you can see how it will encompass and be a part of that day as a whole, and whether or not it's achievable in that day, whether you should move it to the next day. Let's talk about, though, if you maybe you're in a season where you feel like you don't have much to plan. I get that kind of feedback a lot, where you might be in a season of not much to do. Now, always be in a position of reevaluating your life, of finding out, you know, what can be approved upon. So I really feel that I know that even when children have left the nest or whatever, that you can definitely still have a very full life and utilize 2 pages of some planning. And let me tell you why. I know that even my mom, who's going to be 70 this year, she has always led a very fulfilled life. Now, I've talked about this before. And so there are so many things also that you can do. And that is just not only still baking for, it's going to be dwindled down to probably just you and a spouse, or even if it's just you, but it's like, you know, who could you serve? What can you do? You can bake, you can still cook some really good meals. There's exercise to consider, your health to consider, your spiritual walk to consider, and some hobbies you want to pursue, and how you can elevate the everyday to a couple billion notches, you know? It's starting that garden. It's all of these different ideas and things that you can do and pursue, places to visit, people to see, callings to pursue, and those take thought, time, and God's leading. And so I love to, in my morning devotional time, even though my life is busy, it's intentional. So it's things that I'm excited to do and want to do. Now, if I just didn't really plan anything outside of just my kids or what I need to do for them, that really becomes very depressing in a way. It gets to, because you're leaving yourself out of the mix. Motherhood is a very high calling. It's a very high calling. I'm a mom of 8. I mean, I love being my children's mother. And I love even more being a grandmother. But I will have to say that after my 4th baby, that's when I really came to the realization that just focusing on my children was a detriment to me, and I feel that a detriment to even my children, because I feel that children should, you should be leading by example and using your gifts and your talents that God gives you. And you don't have to wait till they leave the nest, but you can use them now. And that way, you know, your children can see you using your talents and your gifts and what you love, because it'll ultimately inspire them by example to do the same. So it will, because you're not filling your own cup and who you are, you can't expect to just deplete yourself on an everyday basis in servitude without first making sure that you're filling yourself up with getting into the Word, getting into some devotions, and building your relationship with God, and also by using and dabbling in fun things that fill you up, that bring you joy, and things that you're good at, to do those things too, whether you want to start a blog or write a book or just start a book club with some women in the neighborhood. I used to do those kind of things all the time. Like I would do a book club with women, or I would have gatherings where we would do like crocheting, or I would always be the hostess where I would, you know, because I love to cook and bake, that I would be the one to, I'll host, you know, and I'll have dynamite food when we get together. It was, you know, I'd be the one to maybe host a homeschool group, you know, and I'll be the mom to do that. All you moms come, I'm going to serve you up because I love you, you know. It's just really using what you're good at to love on other people, and by using what you're naturally kind of bent at and what you love to do, and just hone in on those skills, and God will light your path just step by step along the way until it's just really just exciting in how God reveals those things to you to really just be so fulfilled. Nothing made me want to jump out of bed more to raise children in the thick of it than knowing who I was beyond being my children's mother. So when I was like, oh, I'm gonna write a post today about, and it was about what I love doing, and that was raising children, being a homeschool mom, and cooking and baking elevated gourmet meals. I mean, it was just something that I loved doing, and so I would write about it to share it. And so it's sharing what we're good at, sharing what we're naturally good at, to help others is really what we are called to do, and God will guide you. And so when you dive into your planning, just know that even if you find that you don't have much yet, know that you will. And to have it be something that you are keeping a keen hearing for the call. Your intention is to find that, and by seeking God to guide, and he will. So you want to just fill those pages with intention. I know my mom, ever since us left the nest, there was three of us, that she would be on a row team. She was in the church choir. She pursued, she would do Bible, she would do a book club with her girlfriends, and then she'd write like an itinerary, and she'd have a newsletter, and she just, everything she did, it was over the top. It was over the top. Everything that Planner Perfect brings to the table is honestly rooted in my own mother. That's where I learned all of my dedication to. And she just really lived a really dynamic life. And actually, to the extent where my sister and I would try to give her a call, like, hey, mom, to talk about really silly things, and, you know, the audacity that she would be rowing. I'm like, you know, mom, can we be home? I need to talk about the kind of hair color I need for my hair when I go to get my hair done tomorrow. You know, it was one of those kind of things. But she still does. She went back to school. She wanted to become, she was writing. She was writing short essays. She never stopped. She just never stopped. She was in jail ministries where she would talk to women prisons, and she would go in there and she would preach the word of God to women in prisons. I mean, it was something where she definitely does good with counseling. And so she spent time counseling women. And so she just built this whole thing for herself. And of course, loving on my dad. And she would always continue to make amazing meals for him and love him. And he isn't one to want to go out and do things so much. So she would always go and do her thing, never holding him responsible for her happiness at all. She just would go and fulfill her cup, and she would come back and love him where he's at. And he's always a homebody. And so she just kind of did her thing and filled herself up, and she'd come home and be with him and make sure that he's loved and cared for as well. So let's always, when we go out about this with planning our lives in detail and laying out intentions and living a purpose-filled life, know that too, you are gonna be going out of your comfort zone, because anything worth having is going uphill. It's not gonna be easy, but everything worth having or doing is always at the top. And it's not going to be an easy deal. So, you know, it's going to take getting out of your comfort zone. It's going to take, you know, being in groups of people you don't know. It's like doing something completely new that you've surrounding yourself around new surroundings that you've never been around. It's putting yourself out there when you think that maybe, you know, like you're unqualified. It's going and keep going and failing and then keep going and then failing and then keep going, knowing that you never want to stay comfortable. Like being content with just living that easy place and just getting some groceries or cleaning the house, just you and your husband, and that's it. I want you to push yourself to dream big and allow God to really show you a really dynamic life. I have always loved Jeremiah 29:11, where he says that he has a plan for you, and there's a calling on your life. And even though us as moms, there's so many mothers out there, you know, just know that motherhood alone is not your calling. There's more to you that God wants to use you through. And that's pretty exciting. It's a butterfly type of thing to be used, and just allow him to. Allow God to use you. Let's get started planning. Okay, we're back. Hello. Let's get planning. I've got my stickers. I've got my Avenger bag here that I have my current washi. I like to have that on hand. So I had my Monday done. I've had a beautiful full week of just intentions and plans laid. What I have done is I put a lot of the stuff down that I need to get done. This is such a great thing to do, especially the week prior, when you know that there's something that you want to have bleed over to the next week, or you want to attempt and do the next week. You can put it over and lay these out on the week at a glance. That's super, super, super handy. This is where I'm putting down all the notes of what I want to accomplish, and then I can lay those out with detail within my day. So I have the week at a glance down, when I have my grandson, some different things I got to do, certain things for business, and then certain things I need to do for my family. So I have that all down. So Monday for today, it's going as planned. It was up early. It was my God hour. I'm still really writing it out that I'm letting out Custer. He does not bug me anymore. This has been a game changer for me to actually implement him in my morning routine. Game changer. So let out the dog, feed the cat. If you don't know, Booty Toots, okay, her name's Boots. I call her Booty Toots, but she's kind of a pain because my husband had this crazy idea to give her some wet food. And I knew from previous experience that when you give her wet food, she becomes obsessed and then she only thinks about it. And so I thought, okay, that'll be a nice thing to do for her. And I do it morning and night. And she bugs me and she follows me. And she said, can I have it all day? And can I have it every hour? Can you just keep feeding me it? And one time I remember I was so exasperated by her, and I was so mad. I gave her a whole can and then she barfed. So it's one of those things that no one wins and it's everyone loses. Okay. It's just like Booty Toots. Booty Toots. Okay. So I spend an hour in the Word with, and also I use the War Binder. This has been really great for just my spiritual walk. I'm always looking for great ways to, and in the space, the War Binder has been out, and what a great way to use my journal. I know how I'm going to tweak it for February, but I, especially my sermon notes section is completely full. I have no more space in that. The prayer requests, desires of my heart when you pray over your family, all of that. It's just been really, really beautiful. So I can't wait to do that. That's my little hour. And then shower, dress, laundry, fold to put away, dishes. Last night's dishes from this huge gig I put together with my family. I wasn't able to get the dishes in because the dishwasher was still humming from just the day already. So I couldn't put them right back in. So this morning I needed to tackle that. Different things I wanted to do to share on my social medias. I got laundry, and then I'm starting the Elijah study. And so I like to do this, even though it's a very interactive book, I really recommend this. I love Priscilla Schreier. Oh my gosh, I can't even know where to begin. And so I listen to her and with my AirPods while I fold the laundry. And then I kind of continue at night. I'll listen to her and then work in the workbook. So I'll kind of show you how I do that in here. So I do that. And then Blaine is really, he's got a new bearded dragon. So it's a really great learning tool. I love to take little things that they love and use it as learning opportunities. So kind of been studying together on the internet about bearded dragons, where they're from, how to best care for them. And I always love using those as opportunities for learning and things like that, and about these pretty cool reptiles. So he kind of hangs out with him on his shoulder, and it's pretty fun. I'm really happy for him that he loves it. So projects, it's kind of new. I trade off on how I approach different things I like to see in front of my face. I need to talk to my sister about some things we need to do for Jenny and Anna Bake. If you have not seen that, we have a YouTube channel and we're on IG, Jenny and Anna Bake, where each week we take you along through our baking day. So make sure you join us for that. It's so much fun. So I'm almost done with the March box. So I'm still finishing up painting for that. So there's just different things that I needed to do, and I wrote all those down, and I'm about majority of the way through. We're doing leftovers for dinner because I have so many leftovers. So, but my younger boys want me to make waffles. Since it takes me just 10 minutes to do, I'm actually going to have them make it with me and clean up, right? So I'm going to be doing that. And then it's time for the evening routine with the makeup off. And then I'm going to settle in and do the Elijah study for one more hour. And then I'm going to be doing the Flash. We watched the Flash with the boys. And into bed by 10 p.m. Okay, so let's go ahead and go and do our Tuesday. What I don't like to do is take you through an entire week per se. It just gets too long, but I will do some of the nuts and bolts and get detailed for tomorrow. It's kind of like I feel the best way to do it and to approach it. Perfect. I mean, what's wrong with that? Okay, so I've kind of been doing halvesies, or three quarter of the way, for some of the washi these days. Write a Better Story is, of course, mine. And then this one, I honestly have gotten them years ago, girls. So I don't know where. It's like Michael's or something. So let's just have these 2 days as our first days of kind of getting things down and I love just putting it up at the top. And I've just been real clean and practical for January. This is my birthday week. And that's kind of fun. It's on Saturday. So it's, we're in the middle of a snowstorm here in Nebraska. I'm telling you, we're at like 14 inches right now. But suppose that my daughter is, if the store that she's at, is that she's managing, is open, you can count on her being there, okay? She's just one of those do or dyers. So that's when I'm supposed to get the boys. So of course, up early. If I can do the 5 a.m. or I'm gonna. If not, it'll be 6. But I like to lay the intention down. I've got to make sure that I'm at bed by 10 and really like already breathing heavy. Okay. Already in REM. All right. So up early at 5 a.m. and then so coffee with God. And Custer out and feed the cat. And then, okay, so one of the other little fun new things I like to do is to write projects. And I actually have a lot going on this week, so I don't necessarily feel like I need to do, you know, a whole lot. I don't mind being intentional about keeping it low key. And I think that's what I'm definitely going to plan to do. And I will say, I think I may just move over a couple things and things that I can just do while being with babies and chilling. Like, I love it when I can just sit on the floor and do a little something on my phone or a laptop and babies can kind of crawl on me and I can take a moment to kiss and stuff like that, kiss them up. So, email a client and then I need to, work on, I'm going to be working on tip-ins and stickers for March. That's something I can sketch. I always kind of sketch those things out and get in my business planner as well. So those I will pull over. And I actually think I'll pull over one more thing because as my evening is kind of drawing down to a close, I'm actually going to work on, I'm going to go see a functional medicine doctor. So she's a natural doctor that can help. She'll like draw blood and she'll be able to give me the right vitamins because she'll be able to decipher where I'm low and kind of get me up to speed on my health. So work on the papers I need to fill out before my appointment. Okay, so those kind of things I'm going to pull over. Gummy bear comes today. I say that because the kids are looking forward to it so much that I think I'm gonna write it down. I mean, Waylon's been chomping at the bit. It's one of those big ones. And let's see, for dinner, I'm going to think about that and be writing that in. So since I do have them at 7, let's see, I'm gonna think about this for a minute. And then we're gonna clean up. Whole family. Chip in. I'm also making it where family dinners are a priority as much as I can. So I'm gonna have the boys set the table for dinner. I know my mom always taught me, and she was very
adamant about knowing which side the fork goes on. I like to pass that on to my kids. I've always done that. So I'm going to make sure I did it. I've been doing it lately and I have to keep reminding them because I have a couple boys who really don't care, you know? And when you really don't care, you just don't care so much that you don't remember because you don't care. That's why I like to learn child-led because then they retain it. But in this instance, it's going to be a little tough love and they're going to have to set the table and they're going to have to do it the right way. So let's go. Boys set the table for dinner. It's good for my sons to know that. And they can also help with dinner. And I am also employing Waylon. I like for him to be a part of the dinner and to help set the table and the boys do the salad and teach my boys how to dress a salad. It's very, very important. And then I also think I'm going to do some in the afternoon. You know what? I think I'm going to do it just with him in the morning. I like to do a little one-on-one. I'm going to do his, I got this Bible that I had with my other babies. So I'm going to do some Bible work. They're just Bible stories. He loves books, so with Waylon and Wesley. Of course, he'll try to chew the pages, but I'm gonna do, that's what we can do in the morning after I get him, because then I will be showering, and then that's when I get Blaine showered, and then I make my bed, and I start the laundry. And then grab the boys. So I then will do breakfast. And I think I'll do either a French toast. I have my homemade bread. You'll see an Anna and Jenny bake that stuff. I utilize my bread all week in that regard in this way, in particular French toast or waffles for some, whichever they want. And then, you know what I'm going to need to do? I am so low. I'm telling you, we have 14 inches of snow right now. It's like crazy town. We're very much so snowed in, even though I've got four-wheel drive. It's just one of those things that I don't want to go out. You know what I'm saying? It's like, I don't want to go outside. It's like, please no. And then, you know, try to push my big old grocery cart across, you know, sloppy snow parking lot. It's always like half done. Of course, it's, you know, it snows on top of what they tried to plow out. And so I just don't want to do that. So you know what I'm going to do, girls, is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to order through Thrive Market and Amazon. So write out a big grocery plan and list for the week and order through Thrive Market and Amazon Pantry. I'm gonna do that for some of those more pressing things that I can do. And so I'll feed them and then we will clean the kitchen. Sometimes what I'll do is I'll utilize the boys in other ways. So I'm going to have them watch Waylon while I clean and Wesley. But I will say, and I'll show you tomorrow, I got him a high chair. And so now he sits in there and eats all day. So he's like boots. Okay. I'm telling you, that boy is such a good eater. It's so enjoyable to watch him eat. I can't even handle it. So I got him that so I can actually, I can clean the kitchen and be near while he's mowing on some really good food. So clean the kitchen and watch Waylon and Wes while I get the morning tidied up. And then I will have fun with the boys with the gummy. I'm going to take some pictures, especially for Abby, my daughter, Waylon's mama. And, you know, then for fun, what we can do is do a science experiment. I've got several boxes. So do a with the boys. That'll be so fun. And then for lunch, we can do sandwiches. Homemade mac and cheese. And you know, for me and my husband, I've got that sourdough bread. I just may do a panini with that then for tomorrow. So. Okay, so they're cleaning up with me, and then this is where my grandbabies, boys home at 7. I meet up with my daughter, so I pack up the boys in the snow, take them home. Kind of hoping my daughter tells me that it's a snow day, because I'm telling you, that's such a, it's kind of hard to transport babies and do all that in the snow, but you know, what are you going to do? So I've been kind of putting some stickers on here and making it all cute and inspiring. Gotta have the coffee one. So then home, and usually I am, you know, completely dead tired. I will say here, but it's always a good tired, you know that child rearing tired, but then when you bring in the driving with it, that's always a little extra. So, but I'm gonna do also feed my starter, feed Claire. Mind you, she's doing fantastic, so I love her and she's doing so good. Home, and then my evening routine. I do live drive times. I love to listen to my favorite pastors. It's Tony Evans right now. I'm completely putting him on a loop. So I've been listening to Tony Evans. And then then what I'll do is I will put in my AirPods. And this is when I will do my Elijah study and finish all the clothes and put away. I want my laundry room spotless, everything spotless. The kitchen should be cleaned up before I take the boys home. So then it's the really download time then. So then I can focus on my older boys' jammies, makeup off, and then flash. I'm telling you, we have a whole routine. Okay. So we're going to watch some Flash. So we kind of pile up. I'm telling you, my boys, I mean, they get so close. Like, they're literally, like, behind me, on top of me, and then to the side of me. And so we just sit there and watch. And maybe we'll make some popcorn. That sounds like fun. And we'll have Dad make it. He always makes the best. He uses coconut oil in the whirly pop, you know, the one that you put on your stove top. And, well, for heaven's sakes, now I gotta take the sticker off. You know, I like it that these stickers do peel off. And it makes it so sweet and so delicious. It's like, so he puts a little bit of coconut oil in there and rolls it around with the seeds, and it's so good. And then sprinkles a little kosher salt. I mean, please, so amazing. So this is where I have room here to write down my meal plan. What I do usually is keep it nice and simple. I'll probably do some sort of protein with a salad and then some veggies, and or, you know, a starch. So we shall see. I like to keep it boop, 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 and just kind of basic feeding all boys with nothing fancy. And that really works on these busy days. So I'll be looking in my freezer and seeing, then I got to finish out menu planning for the week. So I think that looks amazing. As I go into here for my Wednesday, I know that I have, this is a day that I do not have grand boys. So this one is going to be where I kind of get maxed. But I will put in just a little bit here to kind of show. But what's fun is that when you really do script your life like this, you just get filled with inspiration and ideas of how you can, of what you can do. And it's like, for your health, now mind you, I cannot wait to incorporate my exercise routine. And judge if you will, you're like, Jenny, you could easily do maybe some exercise while you're waiting for your notar track to get installed. I realize that, but I'm not going to. Okay, now it's still in the garage because it weighs a billion pounds, and because of COVID, they wouldn't put it together. So we have to find a way to lift it. Okay, the base is really heavy, and I'm like, ah. So, but whenever it gets down there, it'll get down, and then it all will be good. So I'm going to use a coffee sticker, and so that will be part of my morning routine where I will, you know, do the treadmill, and I'm part of the, I got the Fit package, so I can get a nice workout in and then go pick up grandbabies too, or start my day on days I do not have them. So Wednesday, that date is the 27th. And I'm going to be putting projects right here because it's definitely project filled. And even prepping the pages this way and leaving it so then I can just kind of plunk and drop, I've really got a lot of pages, a lot of things to do specifically on each day. And that's also the beauty of it. When you have several things that you've got going on, you really kind of can take them step by step so that nothing is overwhelming on the day you have to do it. So if me and Annie are filming on a Friday for a baking day on Saturday, it's kind of like, you know, what can I do this day for this day? What can I do on Thursday for Friday's filming that makes it better? And then better yet, what do I need to do on Wednesday to make sure Thursday's okay for Friday? So it's really just this broad vision. It's an overall view of your life. It's where are you headed? Where's God taking you? What are you inspired about? It's just one of those things. And so it's just, this is such a beautiful way to lay out those plans that are on your heart, and as God guides you each day for the whole broader vision of where you're headed and where you're going, and it's all documented. But thank you for joining me on with this plan with me, and until next time, bye you guys.